which seemed to take forever to get there. And then when we got there, it was just like, you could smell America. It was just incredible. And it was even more incredible because they had palm trees like the Beverly Hillbillies. I was so excited. Didn't take much to make me excited in those days. Anyway, I had an album out at the time called Elton John. And the first single from that album was a song called Border Song. Now, at the same time that we put our record out, Aretha Franklin covered it. I put it out as a single. Now, you can imagine two young boys from England, Bernie and myself, having the Queen of Soul cover your song. We could not believe it. We were absolutely thrilled beyond words. And during my lifetime, I was lucky enough to meet her, to record with her, to play with her, to sing with her, and to hang out with her. And when I was growing up listening to her records, I could never have imagined that in a million years. And she did her last ever concert at a benefit for the Elton John AIDS Foundation in New York. And it was beyond the Divine Cathedral on the west side. And she was very ill. It was about 6 months before she passed away. She was this thin, and I said to her before the show, I said, listen, I'll go on and do it because you're too frail. She said, no. She said, I let you down last year, I'm gonna do it. She came out and sat at the piano like this with an incredible band and sang for an hour and a quarter. And everybody who was there just broke down and cried because she was beyond great that night. She was incredible. She was otherworldly. And it was just one of the most incredible moments of my life. And I love you, Aretha. Thank you for everything you did for me.
Let us live in peace. Let us fight the fight.